Hi guys, welcome back to the Topic Tuesday at the Exilva blog. We're here today, I'm joined by my colleague Otto Soidinsalo. Thanks for coming back to Topic Tuesday, Otto.
Thanks for the invitation. It's always nice to be here.
Thank you. So we have an interesting topic today. I've searched and read some articles that China is doing a quite big change in how they think about the environmental policies. And they have a 70% reduction aim on greenhouse gases. And actually from 1st of January 2018, China put a green tax on product solutions as a consequence of this. And this is a step towards a lower emission society. And at the same time, that will affect a lot of the product systems that's out there. And we're talking about coatings today. So, for instance, and then Otto, what's your take on this this new type of thinking from the governments with regards to the regulatory aspects, and how will this affect the product systems, you think?
Well, I think that it's, first of all, I think there's a major impact on the development and in innovation in coatings, because people know that solvent-borne systems are really durable if you really want to have a long-lasting coating. Yeah. So, for example, in containers, you use those for sea cargo, so you have a salt and everything. So people know also that there are some challenges still. You have water-based coatings which are more or less equivalent,
yeah.
But still there are some challenges. So I think this will push the companies to develop more and more the water-based systems,
yeah.
So that the whole industry will kind of get a kick and go further. So when it comes to binders, when it comes to rheology modifiers and so on.
Do you think that we will get also an improvement, or I would say also a new development going on in the rheology modifiers area, for instance?
Well, I think that it's it will affect everything.
Yeah.
So when you have a new binders, you are basically forced to do new formulation.
Yeah.
And I think there will be also a lot of room for new rheology modifiers, more efficient ones and more compatible ones.
Yeah. So this is a very effective way of changing innovations in a way, because it's a sudden force that comes in, and you need to do adaptments and changes in both the products and the way you produce it in order to comply with these new regulations.
Yeah, I think it's always the most effective way when there is a government sets new rules and it really forces to people to change.
Just a recap for me, what type of water-based systems do we have for these typical, let's take coatings as an example here. What type of product systems have you typically been seeing, like epoxies or
epoxies, acrylics.
Yeah.
So if we talk about like metal coating,
yeah.
So those are the two most common ones.
Yeah, right. Have we done anything on this water-based systems that we could share?
Well, we have already one water formulation where we kind of were studying that how cellulose fibrils, how compatible they are in a two-component epoxy systems and what is the performance.
Yeah, okay, cool. We actually put that as a download here today. So if you're interested in taking a look at our sample here and also the context that we did the test in and the formula and some results, feel free to download the bulletin of today attached to this blog post. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. And it will be very interesting to follow this environmental trend going forward.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Thank you guys for tuning in to the Topic Tuesday. See you in 2 weeks.